left lead. So what I'm going to do here is I'm going to do a roundhouse kick. Right now I'm in outside range, so I'm trying to close the gap a little bit, or I might be here. So my goal is to try to hit him here, but Tom's going to switch leads and step backwards on that first one. I'm going to keep the synergistic movement of this turn. Since I landed here, my body was going this way. I'm going to continue that twist with a spinning side fist or claw or whatever. It might hit his hand and block it up. There may be an opening, and I can't quite reach it, so I'm going to do another kick here and finish off with the kick I started. So initially, my kick I wanted to do with my rear leg, roundhouse kick there. I'm still going to do that kick at the end. So he steps back, I spin around, there's a distractor, and I still get him with that kick. Tom does it to me, so the rear leg's here. I step back, he spins side fist, he may or may not get me there, and there's the target. And then we'll do it from the right lead. So again, I'm going to kick him, and if he doesn't, if he don't move on the first one, this is what I want to do. But he's going to move back and switch lead, so I'm just going to keep the momentum going, and then finish off with the kick I started. So right lead again, he's aiming here, I'm stepping back, he spins fisting, he misses, but he gets me in the end. So the idea here, again, my back leg's here, one, two, three. Or if my right leg's here, roundhouse, spin, roundhouse. So you may get him on that spin fist, the side fist, or the claw, or the chop, or you may miss him on that as well and get him with that final kick there. So practice that.